Hi, it's Maggie the Irish Gypsy here to bring you your October 2018 mid-month general readings. Thank you so much for joining us here today and welcome to any newcomers. I am back home in California after being in Europe for the last 3 months. Although my California background looks a little different than what it did because I moved right before I left for Europe. So I'm still in the process of getting pictures put up and all of that. So thank you for those of you who continue to follow me no matter where I'm traveling to. I do like to travel quite a bit. And thank you for all your likes, shares, and subscribes. And for all of my clients out there, both regular and new, thank you for also following me and continuing to keep me so busy with personal one-on-one readings. And as most of you know, if any of you are interested in a personal one-on-one reading with me, you can get more info and contact details by going to my YouTube channel's homepage and clicking on that little about button, or you could click on the description bar of any of the videos that I post. Please feel free to email me directly at maggie1mcguire@gmail.com. I would be delighted to work with you and set up a reading as quickly as we can. Turnaround time is pretty fast because I do readings full-time, 5 to 6 days a week. It is what I do. So if you're interested, send me an email. We'll go from there. I do a wide variety of different types of readings in all areas of life, of different lengths and times too. So I look forward to hearing from you, those of you who are interested. You can also find me on the smartphone app Instant Go under Irish Gypsy. That link is also provided. That's a great way to access me for quick answers to quick, easy questions. All right, let's move right into this reading. This is for the fire sign of Aries, our lovely Rams. Let's see what's in store for the remainder of October 2018. So we're looking at the last couple of weeks of October. For additional clarification, if you know your rising and your moon sign, watch those videos as well. General readings can always resonate a little differently for everybody watching, although the energy and advice always remains the same regardless of what area it's in. All right, Aries, let's see what's in store for you for the next couple of weeks. We have the Five of Swords, followed by the Three of Pentacles. We have the Three of Wands, followed by the Four of Swords. And from the bottom of the deck, your overall energy and guidance is the Six of Wands. I love your overall energy. You have two cards which represent victory and triumph, though it looks like it's probably been a bit of a ride getting there. Your overall energy, your crowning card from the bottom of the deck, overall energy and focus for the remainder of October, is the Six of Wands. This is a card that represents victory and triumph after a struggle. You can see that the man on this horse, he's riding back into town. He went off to accomplish something, struggle with something, achieve something, and he's been victorious, triumphant, and he's riding back into town. Prancing, dressed in his finest, his horse looks like it's been, you know, groomed within an inch of its life. And he's receiving recognition and praise and applause and accolades from the people in the audience. Sometimes this can represent public recognition as well. Some of you might be receiving recognition for something. Some of you might be receiving a promotion, a bonus, or be in the public eye somehow in a really lovely sort of you know, yay, I did it kind of way. Six of Wands is a significant victory too. We're not talking a minor victory here too. This is victory which was not easy to come by, but you've been victorious and triumphant and successful with something. Which leads us into the first two cards around the middle of the month or so. We have the Five of Swords and the Three of Pentacles. So the Five of Swords is also technically a card of victory. And I say technically because it represents victory which comes at a cost. And the question is usually, you know, has this victory been worth it? Did what I have to endure or do worth, you know, my winning or coming out on top? And sometimes the answer is yes, and sometimes it's no. You can see this man has just finished a battle or a challenge of some kind, and his opponents or foes or whatever he's been struggling with is defeated. He's gathered up on the ground behind him. He's gathered up all their swords, and he's holding his own aloft in victory. But he looks tired, worn out, exhausted. He's bleeding from a little cut on his forehead. If you can see that, I don't know if you can see, I can't see. I know it's on this card, but I don't have my glasses on. So I can't see it all that well because I'm getting old. But anyway, he's bleeding from a little cut on his forehead. So this victory, his winning, his coming out on top, it's been a hard-won battle. Sometimes the people on the ground behind him can represent a victory or coming out ahead. It may have come at the cost of personal relationships, a personal relationship or personal relationships. I mean, sometimes I've seen this card come up in work and career where somebody's been so driven and so ambitious that they kind of hurt other people or ruin relationships or cut off, you know, other people on the way up. So sometimes, you know, the answer is yes and sometimes it's no. Has this battle been worth it? Is continuing this battle worth it if some of you are still engaged in a struggle or a challenge of some kind? And again, sometimes the answer is yes and sometimes it's no. I'm inclined to feel that it is because your overall energy is a lovely, positive, victorious energy. So what clarifies the Five of Swords is the Three of Pentacles. And this is a card of teamwork. It's a card that represents building something that requires more than just you as a part of it. And it can also represent, you have two threes here, and I like threes because they're cards of manifestation. They're cards of beginning to see the fulfillment of something, beginning to see manifestations of something larger, meaning because you have the Three of Wands, which represents that too, the beginnings of seeing something manifest, meaning, and the Three of Pentacles is working with other people to achieve that. So you have like one thing that needs to be accomplished, some overriding goal or big thing that needs to be built or project. There's some goal in mind and everybody agrees that this goal needs to be accomplished or something needs to happen or something needs to be created or built or managed or something. There's one goal on the table everybody agrees on. The Three of Pentacles is a card about working with other people in order to accomplish that, which isn't always easy because working with other people represents and requires compromise and negotiation, which is also in the energy of the Three of Pentacles. Compromise and negotiation with other people. Sometimes it represents working with other people to accomplish something. Maybe everybody's got their own opinions and ideas and you've got to kind of get everybody on board. Everybody's kind of needs to get on board with how something needs to be accomplished. And sometimes that's not easy because sometimes you have to do this with people you might prefer not to do it with. Or it might be a group of people that you like, but you know, getting everybody on board on how to accomplish something is not always easy. And I think for you, because it clarifies the Five of Swords, it particularly wasn't easy. So for some of you, I mean, you know, general reading, this is going to mean different things for different people. Let me look at your elemental energy. You don't have any cup cards here, so it likely was probably not strongly in the relationship arena of your life, although it may have included relationships and working with other people. I'm not getting a strong, you know, sense of energy around love and romance. It could be that some of you were involved with, you know, maybe you're on a project with people at work or in your community or even within your own family system. And there was something that needed to be accomplished, built, worked on, and maybe getting everybody on board with that was not easy or agreeing was not easy. You could even apply this to a legal situation of getting everybody, getting opposing parties to kind of agree on an outcome or a settlement or an offer or something of some kind if it's not the actual, you know, a working together on a project. Again, that could be a work project, some other kind of project. It could be in the community at large. I'm getting nonprofit for some reason. You might be working with some group or a nonprofit organization on building something, maybe something concrete or a project of some kind. But getting this all together and getting it accomplished and getting everybody on the same page and getting it started looks like it was quite a job. But you are beginning to see that pay off because at or towards the end of October 2018, we have the Three of Wands and the Four of Swords. So the Three of Wands is a card. It's another three. It's a card of beginning to see the manifestations of something. So this man there's some big goal that you have in mind, some vision that you have. It may be a long-term goal or, you know, something major that you want to have accomplished. But there's steps to getting there. There's small goals that need to be accomplished and met on the way to making that final vision a reality. So the Three of Wands represents, you know, being still kind of early on in the path, but starting to see things pay off, starting to see the initial work and the foundation which you've worked hard to lay with other people, starting to see that pay off. The vision hasn't been accomplished yet, but you're starting to see things kind of come together. Now, it's clarified by the Four of Swords, which is a card of rest, respite, restoration. Sometimes this is a card that comes up when somebody's feeling, you know, tired, maybe overworked, exhausted. It's a card that can represent advice and maybe taking better care of yourself, particularly in sleep. It represents a temporary withdrawal from the challenge, the project, the struggle, the conflict, if there is one. I say temporary because this man is a soldier. You can see he's dressed for battle or challenge or the project. He's taken his helm off and his hand gauntlets to rest. Now, the three swords which are pointing down at him represent the battle, the challenge, the project, whatever it is that this represents for you. And his own sword, meaning his own job, his own part in it, what he is there to do, is still lying close by his hand should he need it. But for the time being, he's not engaged. He's taken a temporary kind of step back to rest, restore himself, maybe take a little bit better care of himself because he's feeling kind of tired. And then he's going to go back in and you know, complete or continue with whatever the challenge or the battle or the project is. So at or towards the end of October 2018, Aries, you might be feeling a bit tired, worn out, exhausted. You're starting to see the beginnings of things play out. It looks like it's been a bit of a struggle, particularly those of you who this represents having to work with other people, compromise and negotiate with other people. And it looks like it's been difficult because, you know, that Five of Swords, it's a hard-won victory. But it is victory, and it is a significant victory, and you are starting to see that pay off. You are starting to see the beginnings of the manifestations towards whatever this bigger goal or this long-term vision is. So good for you. So Aries, that pretty much wraps up your October 2018 mid-month readings. I hope that you enjoyed it or found it helpful, because that's why we do these. Again, if any of you are interested in a more personal one-on-one reading just for you, with me, live or recorded, you can get more info and contact details by going to my YouTube channel's homepage, clicking on that little about button, or you can click on the description bar of all the videos that I post. Please feel free to email me directly at maggie1mcguire@gmail.com. I would be most happy to work with you. I do lots of different types of readings, from 15 minutes up to an hour and a half in increments of 15 minutes. I do love and romance, of course, reconciliation spreads, compatibility charting, career, work, and finance, as in addition to investment readings. And I also do 6 and 12 month overviews, which you can do at any time during the year. They just look at what's coming in all the main areas of your life for the next 6 or 12 months. But they seem to be particularly more popular towards the end of the year when people are looking at the next year. So there's that to consider. And I also do channeled messages from passed on loved ones, as long as there was a strong emotional connection. And gift readings as well, which, like the overviews, you can do it. You can gift someone for birthdays or any time of the year just because you feel like it. But they're always a bit more popular towards the end of the year as gifts during the holidays. So something to think about. You can also find me on the smartphone app Instant Go for fast answers to the quick, easy questions. And that link is also provided. So, Aries, I will see you all in a couple of weeks for the November 2018 general readings. And until then, as always, I wish you joy, peace, blessings, and a happy life. Take care, and I hope to see you soon. Bye-bye.